Hey y'all, I'm about to go out and feed the meat chickens, and I just wanted to update you on how I feel about them. Since it's been a little while since I put out that video talking about not loving having meat birds. Say that while they're not my favorite animal on the farm, I do like them a lot more now that they're out on the pasture. One of the nicest things about having them on pasture is that we can move them every day. They're on new grass and I don't have to worry about bedding, and it really doesn't smell or anything because they're constantly moving and their manure is being moved all around the property. That being said, there are still some pretty big downfalls. The first you saw while I was feeding them, they like to jump out this door as soon as I open it. Even if there's food in there, they just want to run around and they see new grass and they want it, and I understand, but it is pretty annoying. Another downside to the meat birds, and this is probably for any meat bird, they are hungry all the time. I mean, all the time. I just fed them actually not that long ago. This morning when I was doing chores, and it's now early afternoon, and they were out of food and acting like they were, you know, starving, so I brought them some more out. And it's probably almost already gone. Like, always hungry. Now for some positives. I really love this tractor. It is a little bit too heavy. I can't move it on my own because we put solid sides on the back. But the fact that their manure and them scratching around on the grass is going to make better pasture for our goats is just kind of awe-inspiring. This tractor design is by Farm Marketing Solutions, and really, really good. I see why a lot of people use this tractor. Since having them out on the grass, this is the only area that they have done so far, and they're going to do the rest of this backyard. And probably by the time they get to the end, will be about time for them to process. I had actually anticipated them having to do this entire backyard, our front yard, and maybe this side yard over here, but they're growing so fast that I don't think we're gonna make it to do that much property, which actually works out well because we are planning to order another batch of chickens. When I posted the last video, I actually got a lot of really encouraging feedback about the way that a lot of ours didn't make it, being an irregularity. So I am going to try again. I think, however, we're gonna try a different hatchery as well as a different breed. The Cornish, while they're growing crazy well, it's almost too well for me. It almost seems unnatural. I don't really like it. Not hating on the Cornish cross lovers out there, do your thing. But I like something just a little slower growing. So I think we're gonna go with like the Red Rangers. Since the chicks got here about 6 weeks ago, we've gone through about 250 pounds of feed, which I'm keeping track of because I would like to know how much it costs for us to raise meat chickens. And so I'm actually keeping track for once. So roughly 250 pounds so far. And at the earliest, we have about 2 more weeks to go with them. So for the pasture, that means they have at least 14 more moves, and we have much more space than that back here. Wherever these guys leave off though is where we'll just start up the next batch of chickens and keep moving them. So it's not a problem if they don't get through this whole backyard. Since there are so many new faces on the channel now, I just want to take a second and kind of talk about why we raise our own meat. I've gotten a couple comments on things, especially about the rabbits. A lot of people aren't comfortable with the idea of meat rabbits, but we are. Our goal for this year is to raise 100% of the meat that we need for our family. And one of the easiest ways for us to do that is to raise meat rabbits, meat chickens, and we did the pigs. We have already processed those pigs. There is a video coming out probably next week that will have the whole processing on it. You won't see the dispatch, so you don't have to worry there, but it will show my husband and his friends skinning the pig, and then we'll be talking about that experience and how we felt about it. This is just a good time to say my little piece about eating meat. It is my opinion, and it is a very strong opinion, that if you eat meat, you can't judge me for raising and processing my own. And that's because the things that you buy in the store or that you buy from some other farmer, or if you buy it in general, that used to be an animal and it is now processed and now you are eating it. Now, I get that people are like, oh, but they're like your pets, but they're not. I actually have a post on Instagram talking about processing meat and why I believe the things I do and why I believe in living the way that we do. And I'm gonna link it in the description so that I'm not just repeating the same thing over again. But essentially, and it boils down to this, if you are going to eat meat, I believe that you should be able to take the responsibility on yourself to end the life of an animal for you to consume its products. That being said, if you're a vegan, that's completely okay. I am not judging. However, because I go about not judging other people's way of eating, I request that you do the same for me and my family. Ethically, this is the best that I could possibly do for any animal, is to raise it myself with respect, with love, and let it have one bad day. So that's your update for the meat chickens. I like them more. I'm still not a huge fan, but they're doable. I will still keep you guys up to date. The next video I do on them will probably be our processing video, or at least talking about processing them. And then I'll have a very rounded opinion by that point. So you can look forward to that. If you liked hanging out in our little corner of YouTube today, please consider liking, sharing, or commenting down below. This just tells the YouTube algorithm that you liked this video and that it should show it to other people. And it's a really non-committal way of supporting us. Now, if you feel like committing to us, a great way to do that is to subscribe and hit the notification bell, and that just means you're gonna get a little pop-up every time we put out a new video. If you'd like to get to know us on a little bit more personal of a level, a great way to do that is to check us out on Instagram. I post there on a daily basis. If not an actual post, then I'm updating our stories very regularly. It's a great place to see things as they're happening instead of on YouTube, where there's a little bit of a delay. So thank you guys for hanging out with me as I update you on my opinion on these birds. If you missed the last video where I talked about not really liking them, I will link it up here and down in the description below. So until we meet again, bye y'all.